you know.
And this turned off a lot of the black passes.
What?
You think it turned off a lot of the black passes.
That's exactly what I was going to say, because I remember Lamerson and the churches in Bed-Stuy that had been pivotal in the integration movement were reluctantly or hesitantly supporting community control. Really, it was a gradual process, because that board really forms in 66, right? And the presence of these militants, you know, it's interesting to think about to what degree they were silenced by the board itself or not, and to what degree their rhetoric, which was not necessarily the board's, it was not necessarily the school board.
That's right.
But it was there, it was on the streets, it was on the street corner.
And I must say, the president of the Brownsville, once you know Brownsville, what was the Reverend C. Herbert Oliver, was still around. I just saw him a few months ago. We were on a panel together. But yeah, for the most part, they sort of stayed away, and in large parts, they were weary of black power advocates.
External.
That's right. It's outside of their control, also.
That's right.
It's outside of their control. You know, I just remember Reverend Garvin Taylor telling me, "Yeah, I used to keep baseball bat in case the militants came around." Okay. None of them did show up to threaten him, but I mean, they also had this sort of